My name is Nick. I have a question. Are you happy with what you do every day? I think not everyone. Many people in our world cannot decide what they want to do in the future. So, they just get knowledge which are not interesting for them. Lots of children absorb information like sponges without willing to, like sponges at school without willing to do so. I want to offer a system which will improve the current situation. But this is only the alpha version. For you to understand how it works, imagine the next situation. A toddler goes to kindergarten where he learns how to read, write, and calculate. From the age of 6 to 9, he goes to the school and gets basic knowledge in subjects like science, art, linguistics, sports. At the end of each year, teachers record his results and assess his achievements into this subject. If a student progresses faster than the program defines, he can skip a year and take the program according to knowledge. At high school, the student chooses several subjects from a suggested list. These chosen subjects are studied until the age of 18. While doing so, he can change and, in case of success, shift to a higher level if possible. If you are over 18 and you want to keep studying or you aren't satisfied with your career path, you have to pay a fee. The older the student, the higher are the fees. Otherwise, the student goes to work where the employer defines your job according to the grades in his school certificate. The highest grade in a specific subject, the more employable you are. If a student wants to get back to school, while working, his employer must give him a study leave. Now I'm going to show you how it works following a guy called Tom, whose life I have made up in my imagination. Since early childhood, Tom was going to kindergarten until he reached the age of 6. Further on, it took Tom 3 years to finish the program. He chose mathematics for his senior classes. But in a while he got fed up with math and he decided to take up art course doing painting until the age of 18. After graduating from school, he got the highest grade in painting, which was 11 points. He was employed as a game designer to make stunning space backgrounds for games. But 3 years later, he resigned while his painting became popular and very expensive. The price of one painting was equal to the value of a cottage. He became rich and famous, but he went back to school to study guitar playing for 3 years. But most interesting, it and quit. That is how he found a job in a design company again, and his new works were a high quality and price again. Later, he set up on his own design company and hired many people of high skills to work for him. After 2 years of absolute success, the company was sold, making Tom a rich man. He spent the rest of his life painting for his own pleasure. This is only one possible variant of how Tom could spend his life. The point is that he always had a chance to develop and to study. Wouldn't you or your children like to live a life of pleasure? think and make conclusions. I wish you all the best. Thank you for your attention.